Kiran Rijiju presents Vakf Amendment Bill in Lok Sabha. The BJP-led government is set to introduce the Vakf Amendment Bill 2024 in the Lok Sabha. This important legislation aims to amend the Vakf Act 1995. The bill seeks to address key issues related to the powers of state Vakf boards, streamline the registration and survey of Vakf properties, and tackle the problem of encroachments. Kiran Rijiju, Union Minister for Law and Justice, has presented the Vakf Amendment Bill.
Permission, I rise to move for leave to introduce the Vakf Amendment Bill 2024. आपके माध्यम से खास करके कांग्रेस पार्टी को कहना चाहता हूं, ये अमेंडमेंट आज सरकार इस सदन में ला रहे हैं, ये एक तरीके से आप लोगों ने जो भी कदम उठाया है, आप लोगों ने जो भी चाहा है, वो आप नहीं कर पाया, वही चीज करने के लिए हम आज ये अमेंडमेंट प्रपोज किया गया है। अब जब मैं इसका विवरण दूंगा तो आप बिल्कुल सहमत होगा मैं जो आपके सामने में बात रख रहा हूं। और दूसरी बात, इसमें हम लोग सब चुने हुए प्रतिनिधि हैं। मैं अपना बात तर्क रखने से पहले ही बताना चाहता हूं, इस बिल का समर्थन कीजिए, करोड़ों लोगों का दुआ मिलेगा। अगर आप विरोध करोगे, चंद लोगों ने पूरा वक्त बोर्ड को कब्जा करके रखा हुआ है और आम मुसलमान लोगों को जो न्याय इंसाफ नहीं मिला उसको सही करने के लिए ये बिल लाया गया है। इतिहास में दर्ज होगा कि ये बिल को कौन कौन समर्थन किया है और किसने विरोध किया है, ये इतिहास में नाम दर्ज होगा। इसलिए इस बिल का विरोध करने से पहले आप सोचिएगा।
Asaduddin Owaisi of AIM has strongly criticized the Vakf Amendment Bill presented in Parliament today, describing it as discriminatory and arbitrary. Owaisi argues that the bill infringes on the fundamental right to freedom of religion guaranteed by the Constitution. He contends that the bill could enable the government to not only take control of Vakf properties but also those belonging to dargahs and mosques. His comments highlight the ongoing controversy and debate surrounding the proposed legislation. Veteran left leader and former West Bengal Chief Minister Buddhadev Bhattacharji passed away this morning at his residence in South Kolkata. He was 80 years old. Bhattacharji had been unwell for some time, battling respiratory issues that often required hospitalizations. Last year, his health took a serious turn when he contracted pneumonia and had to be placed on life support. Despite these challenges, the seasoned CPM leader had shown resilience and made a comeback, but sadly, he has now left behind a legacy of dedicated public service. Nobel Peace Prize-winning economist Muhammad Yunus has returned to Bangladesh to lead an interim government after weeks of intense student-led protests forced Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina to resign and flee to India. Upon his arrival at Hazrat Shah Jalal International Airport in Dhaka on Thursday, the 84-year-old Yunus expressed his emotions, saying, "It's good to be back home." He arrived on a flight from Paris via Dubai, marking a significant moment in Bangladesh's political landscape as the country navigates through this period of transition. A powerful earthquake with a magnitude of 7.1 struck off Japan's southern coast on 8 August, prompting a tsunami advisory. The quake was centered in waters off the eastern coast of Kyushu, Japan's southern main island, at a depth of about 30 kilometers. Authorities quickly urged residents to stay away from the coastline as a precaution. Fortunately, there have been no immediate reports of injuries or significant damage. The situation is being closely monitored by the Japan Meteorological Agency,